What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
And in today's video, we're taking a look at LEGO set 7198 Fighter Plane Attack from LEGO Indiana Jones. This set came out in 2009, so 10 years ago. Of course, it's based on The Last Crusade, the third Indiana Jones film. And this set comes with three figures, is for ages 7 to 14 years old, has 384 pieces, and comes with two planes that are actually surprisingly well built, but we'll get to that here in just a minute. So, I've been picking up Indiana Jones LEGO sets, but here's the stipulation, guys. I make sure that my sets have the box. My goal is to get every single Indiana Jones set in the box because I had most of them as a kid, but interestingly, this is one of the sets that I didn't have as a kid. So this was my first time ever building it, and we're gonna break it down here in the review. So let's take a look at the instruction and box because, you know, this set is so old, you guys may not have ever seen it up close. Then we'll take a look at the figures, then the set as a whole, then we'll break it down and I'll give you my final thoughts. Also, if at any point you decide, hey, I think I might want this set, be sure to check the link in the description below. I've linked out where you can pick it up. So let's jump in and take a look at this set. All right, and the box is actually too big to fit in my white space, so we'll take a look at it on the floor here. So this is the box, got some great design here. Of course, it shows us our minifigures, shows us everything that's going on in the set. When you flip it over, you can see that it kind of shows you what play features are here. The wings, of course, from when it goes through the tunnel pop out. That's pretty cool. And then, of course, this piece here flies off like Indiana Jones' dad shot it. Henry Jones is his name, of course. And then there's that little storage area there. So pretty cool. Really nice. Some advertisements for the other sets from this wave and for the LEGO Indiana Jones video game. So let's go ahead and dive in and take a look at the instructions. So here we've got the instruction booklet, basically the exact same design as the box. When you open it up, you can see the pages are made to look like it's a weathered old notebook or something like that. Then when you flip to the end, there's some advertisements for that last wave of Indiana Jones set from 2009. The Venice Canal Chase, the Temple of Doom, that's one I never had. This set from Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, never had that. And then of course this one, which I've reviewed, I'll have a card pop up. But I had this one as a kid, but I didn't have any of the other three or the one that I'm about to build for you here. So it was really cool to get this. There's a big advertisement for the LEGO Indiana Jones Original Adventures game. There's a LEGO Club sign up here. And then, of course, there's some advertisements for some old sets on the back. So, Bionicle Man, that tells you how old this is. So, all right, let's go ahead and dive in and take a look at this set. And here we have the minifigure. So in the middle here, we have Indiana Jones, who of course is the same as all of the other Indiana Joneses in the majority of these sets. He's got the brown jacket on, of course. He's got the great khaki pants with the holster design, pretty much iconic as far as LEGO designs go. And then of course the fedora here, and he comes with a little pistol. Move him to the back to make a little room here. We've got Henry Jones Sr., of course, the Sean Connery character from the film. And man, the likeness on this figure is unreal. The face detailing was really, really good for the time way back when these sets came out. So that was really cool. And one little thing that I always loved is on the torso printing here, you can see he's got his little journal right there, the diary. So no printing on the back, no printing on the legs. But once again, you know, some of that is almost nostalgic, honestly, because these figures used to be so, you know, non-detailed. But in any case, then of course we have the German soldier. And if you watch the Indiana Jones movies, of course these were actually Nazis. But, you know, the LEGO was never going to create Nazi minifigures. That would never happen. But it's a cool figure nonetheless. Definitely cool because, you know, LEGO doesn't really make any war-themed figures like that. So it's definitely interesting to get a figure like this because, you know, other than Indiana Jones, I really can't think of any LEGO-friendly theme that would ever give us figures like this. Okay, so up first here, this is the plane that Indiana Jones and his dad use. Pretty iconic from The Last Crusade, of course, one of the humorous scenes of the film. So there's actually an interesting amount of stickers here. We've got two up top here on these little cross stickers. We've got stickers right here on these flaps, which interestingly, that's actually a play feature. There's a little green army remote in there, which is pretty cool. So then we've got a sticker back here, and then we've, of course, got the bullet stickers on the back here, because in the movie, Indiana Jones' dad shoots themselves in the plane, and he says, sorry, we're hit. But anyways, it's a really great little plane. There's these landing gears on the bottom. They don't fold up, they just kind of sit as is, but the wheels do roll, And it kind of makes the plane tilt back like that whenever you're not flying it or swooshing it around. There's a propeller up front that actually moves and works. And it's cool that the plane wings are actually completely symmetrical, as you can see. Looks really good. And then they're actually built up with these telescope pieces. There's four telescope pieces on each side that kind of build up the story of the plane. And it looks really, really good and like a vintage plane. Now, when I was building this, unfortunately, it was missing one piece right here. You can see that it's right there on that side. So that's a bit of a bummer. But to show you what it looks like putting a minifigure in the back cockpit here, you could put Indiana Jones's dad there. And this gun swivels like that. And these are flick fires, too. And they come out, but I don't really know that they're supposed to, like, actually be flick fires. I think they just look cool, and so that's why LEGO did it. Really wouldn't make sense for a plane like this from this era of history to have flick fires. So I don't think that that was the intention, but in any case, let's go ahead and take a look at that German plane. In here, we've got the German plane, which, of the two builds, I actually prefer this one a little bit better. And this is just really cool. It looks like some kind of, you know, World War II fighter jet kind of deal. And, you know, considering LEGO doesn't really make anything based on, like, you know, war sets or anything like that, I definitely think that this is a really accurate and cool representation of this ship. So as you can see, this also has landing gears on the bottom that do roll like that. Again, these have flick fire pieces here, just like that, that shoot out these little bombs. Let me get that in frame. So you can see, let me get that centered up there. Kind of hard to do when you're filming from behind. You can see these pieces here are the flick fire pieces, and there's one on each side, just like that. As far as stickers are concerned, we have a sticker right here. We've got a sticker on the wing here, and those are mirrored on both sides, so that's pretty cool. And looks really good. So you can see that this says MF7198, and of course this is LEGO set 7198, but I'm not sure what the MF stands for. And you can see that the German soldier goes right inside there, and then you can pull that little translucent piece off, and he does sit in there nice and snug. In fact, his legs are even sticking in there, so I'm just gonna leave him in there, but you can see how that goes. And it snaps on just like that. So the propeller moves up front, and that is this plane. So let's zoom out and take a look at this set as a whole, and I'll give you my final thoughts. All right, guys, so needless to say, this is a really, really cool set. It is a little pricey on the aftermarket if you're trying to get it with the box, but if you're not a stickler for the stickers, you should be able to bricklink this pretty easily and pretty cheaply. So drop a comment below, let me know what you think about this set. As I mentioned, I think this set has aged really, really well. It looks good still, and this looks like something that absolutely could come out today on LEGO shelves. So drop a comment below, let me know what you think, and I'll see you guys on the next video. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, feel free to click that subscribe button for more LEGO content coming in the near future. So, thanks for tuning in to today's video, and until next time, build on.